Vertebral body tethering is a way to modulate growth of the spine. And so you need two things. You need growth and you need flexibility. The procedure is done thoracoscopically through some small ports. It's done minimally invasive. And so we're able to visualize things on a camera. And through the scope, then we're able to place instrumentation screws into the anterior part of the spine and then slowly bring correction then as we tension and tether the polyethylene cord. In our study, those were my first 31 patients that I treated consecutively. We followed them for 2 to 5 years, so a minimum of 2-year follow-up. And what we found was 74% of them actually were successful. And so we define success as under 30 degrees when they reach skeletal maturity. Broken tethers showed up at about 48%. So you have to understand that broken tethers are going to happen. But that doesn't mean that there's not a successful outcome. And then our revision rate was otherwise lower than what was also previously reported. Here, we're currently up to about 90 patients that have undergone vertebral body tethering. So we're going to hope to add to our data set. It's really having an impact. As we report it in our study, 93% of our patients have avoided a posterior spinal fusion. So I think that really tells you that vertebral body tethering has its place in the treatment protocol for a child with progressive scoliosis.